Hi everyone, I thought I'd show you how to make a really cool line graph with After Effects since we didn't have time to talk about it in class. So what I've got here is the grid that I made before, and it's three dimensions. You can see that it's all 3D. And I'm going to go to Custom View and press C to get my camera so you can see what I've done here. Basically, I have a blue solid here that I've created, and then I have a couple of the same solid, pale yellow solid. Which I then used the grid effect, applied that to it, and I got one of these, and then I duplicated it to get the other one, and then rotated it in the Z axis. I did the adjustment, so I've got that here. So I'm going to go back to my active camera, and the cool thing about making this grid 3D composition is that I don't actually have to make a graph on this. So I can close this out and then create a new composition. And I'm going to call this new composition line graph. And it's going to be 1920 by 1080, HDTV, square pixels, etc. And I'm just going to drag that grid into it as a composition. So what's really cool about that is that you get a really, really nice effect with this grid, and you don't have to remake it every single time. I'm going to make it 3D. And I'm going to collapse the composition, and that you'll just get used to doing that. So what I'm going to do to create a line graph here is to go to Layer, New, Solid, or you can choose another solid that you've got down there. In this case, I have a bunch of solids, so I'll just drag one down, but you could create a new one. And you want it to be 1920 by 1080, or the exact same size as your composition. So I'll just drag this down. You can always make a new one if you choose to. You just don't want to have too many random solids there, just for organization purposes. So you'll see it just looks like a white, big white box. What I'm going to do is go to Effect up there, or right click, go to Effect, Generate, and then Stroke. And then in Paint Style on Stroke, I'm going to click on Reveal Original Image. What that does is it makes it look as if that solid has disappeared. But it hasn't actually disappeared. What it's waiting for is for you to tell it when to appear. And the way you do that is with a path, what's called a path. So what you do is you use the path tool, which is the pen tool, and you just make some clicks. So I'm going to start at 2-2 here, and then I'm going to move up maybe to, here, and then here, and then, wait, no, whatever you want your graph to look like. This is completely random. But you'll see that this allows you a great amount of flexibility. You can also make curves, which is very cool. You can alter the way in which these points work. So you can delete the points, you can add new ones, you can click on the move tool and you can move it over to wherever you want it to be. And you can also highlight multiples and all that sort of stuff. So this makes what's called a path. And what I want to do is have the stroke follow the path. And so what you do is you click on path and click on mask one. What that stroke did, what that path tool did is it created what's called a mask automatically. And that means you can have multiple masks. So if you have multiple line graphs, you want to follow the same pattern, you can have multiple lines here. And every time you do it, it will create a new mask. And you can have it all within one solid. So it's very easily adjustable. But in this case, I only need one, so I'm going to go to mask one. You'll see it didn't really look like it changed anything, but I'm going to move up forward about 5 seconds, and I'm going to adjust the start point after I make the brush size a little bit bigger. Well, let's make the start point go all the way to 100, so that which it means it would be finished, basically. And I'm going to expand the brush size so that you can actually see what I've done. So in this case, I'm going to have a nice thick line. Maybe 18 is going to be a little thick. The way that you reveal it is by removing the end. So we've had it start to 100%, but we've also had it end, so it's So I'm going to remove end all the way to 0% here. You can see that here's my line. It's a little thick, but I think that's okay for now. I think maybe I'll reduce it a little bit. So we're at 15 or something like that, a little bit tighter. So when we have this piece here, that little red line is not actually there. It's just an illusion. What I do is I animate the start point. So when that happens, at 5 seconds, it is 100% finished, basically. And I'm going to go back to zero in my timeline, and then I'm going to drag start down to zero. So that when I press spacebar to preview it, and I click outside to remove the visibility of the mask, you can see that it draws it and moves it through. In 5 seconds, it will create the entire graph. So pretty cool. You know, you can do a lot more there, obviously. So one thing you can do is to make some colors. So you could go to Effect in the white solid, and you could go to back to Generate maybe and add a ramp, which does a gradient. So let's say I want to go white to black. Okay, so I can have a gradient there that makes it look a little bit more professional. Okay, that's fine. I actually don't think I want to do that. One of the things I might want to do, though, is go to the effect and go to the perspective piece and go to bevel alpha. And what that does is it basically makes it look like it's three-dimensional. You can't really see it here. But when I zoom in, go to 100% here, you can actually see that it's created little edges on the edge of this. I'm going to make it three-dimensional. I'm not going to do that right now. I'll show you why in a second. But you can see that it's made little edges, and you can actually make the edges thicker. So you can see that it actually makes it look very three-dimensional here. I'll make them even thicker to make it more pronounced. So I'll zoom back out, and then we'll make it a three-dimensional layer. And when you make it 3D, it disappears. Why does it disappear? Well, it disappears because it's actually behind the solid you just created. So what you need to do is move down and transform it so that it moves forward. So in position, it's 3D, so you should have this position here. You want to make it into a negative Z space, which brings it closer to you. So this is X, this is Y, this is Z. So I'm going to click, drag to the left, and you'll see it suddenly appeared. And I want to go far enough forward that I think it's going to be in front of both the grid and the solid. Now, remember that those are at different sizes. So once that's done, I could zoom back in to see it if I wanted to. But really the best way to really see it is to create a light. So I am going to left click, go to new, light, or you could just go to layer new light. So I've got a little light here that's up top. It's a spotlight, which is fine for now. So I'm going to move it back in Z space a little bit. Then I'm going to move it over in X space, up in Y space, and then I'll drag this over a little bit. So that looks about like I want it to. Now, what you'll see if I zoom in here is that the grid does show the shadows. However, the line does not. There's a couple of reasons for that, but it's mainly in your material options. So in my material options, I want to say, okay, well, it accepts shadows, it accepts light, so I get the gradient, the slight gradient here. But what I want to make it do is cast shadows. So you'll see that it casts shadows on the background. It does not cast them on the grid. Well, why? Well, because it's pretty much at the same distance as the grid. So I want to go to transform, and I want to move it back a little bit, so towards me more, in Z space. And you can see that now it is casting a shadow on the grid. I want to move it back a little bit more, and you can see it makes more of a shadow. So the further back you move it, the more obvious that shadow is going to be, and you know, you can see it more. And of course, you can choose how much you want that shadow to be, how obvious you want that shadow to be, how diffused you want it to be in the process here. So material options are very, very important. So when I zoom out again to fit, and I click out, press home to go back to the beginning. And then I'm going to press spacebar to... So you can see that the shadow moves here as well as on the grid, and it moves up. Of course, this is going very slowly because it's processing, each step of the way. But if I pause it and move back, you can see it in real time or closer to real time. And you can actually see how cool this process is. So good luck. I hope you enjoy it. Play around as much as possible, and you'll really be able to see the power of being able to make multiples of these, especially if you've got numbers and labels and that sort of stuff.